Keeping the arm straight in the follow through is one of the most beneficial things you can do in the golf swing if you want to improve your ball striking. But for so many of you, this movement proves elusive. Well, today I'm going to share with you one of my absolute favorite drills, the hit hard, stop quick exercise. And today we're not only going to discuss how it works with the irons, but I'm also going to show you how you can benefit from that same drill with the driver. Many of you who followed my channel for a while will know about this drill. Hit hard and stop quick is the go-to drill that I use in my day-to-day coaching, and I'm going to share that with you again. For those of you that have never seen this drill, it could completely transform your ball striking. The concept behind this drill is that you're to hit the ball hard, but try to stop your swing as quickly as you can after impact, focusing on squeezing the elbows and the arms together, keeping the club as far away from me as possible, and putting the brakes on soon in the swing. This is to help train these straight arms. The management of the arms throughout the swing and stopping them from overflexing is something that can absolutely transform your ball striking. I would say that the number one deficiency across the board with poor ball strikers is their inability to manage the radius of their golf swing, meaning their arms are flexing too much on the backswing, they're too flexed on the downswing, they're too bent at impact, and they're certainly too bent in the follow through. So if you can learn to keep your arms straight, it's absolutely going to improve your ball striking. This exercise is such a good way to do that. So what you're going to do is practice swings first, hitting the ground and trying to stop as soon as you can after impact. Okay, keep the arms together. There's a tension there that I'm feeling. This shouldn't be soft and loose. There's a tension that's necessary to help build some structure into the swing. And as I finish, keep my arms together, keep my right shoulder down, so I'm tilted still. That's the position that we're looking to finish in. Then we can go ahead and hit some shots. This will transform your ball striking, I guarantee it. Go to the driving range, try this exercise. Hit hard, stop quick. This is an 8-iron here. I'm just going to go ahead and hit one. The contact is so solid. I've pushed that one out to the right a little bit, but that's landed 135 meters. That's 150 yards. You're going to be able to hit this ball far, but what you're also going to be able to do is really improve the quality of the contact. Let's hit one more. Hit hard and stop fast. Went a little bit further through that time. Strike was still pretty good. Shots pretty much the same. It's gone maybe 4 or 5 yards further. So I've shared that drill with you before, and I'll certainly link the other versions of that video, the hit hard, stop quick drill, in the description at the end of this video. You can go and watch those later. But we've always talked about doing it with the iron. One of the most common questions I get on the channel is, does this drill work with the driver, and would I do a video on it? So let's talk about the driver. So the first thing to say is, when it comes to the driver, most people's flexing limbs and poor arm structure simply gets much, much worse. The club's longer, it's got further to travel around you, the swing gets faster. So all the deficiencies that exist in your iron swing that are causing you to bend your arms and flex your wrists too much are only going to be exaggerated with the longest club. Can this drill work with the driver? Absolutely. So you can definitely do it with the driver. It's just a little bit more difficult to do it well, because the extra speed that the driver swing has tends to want to pull people up and out of that structured finish. So the key here is to really understand where you're trying to stop. Arms together, elbows squeezed, right shoulder lower than the left. We're tilted. And although this is called hit hard, stop quick, and the ultimate goal is to swing hard and stop, start out with the driver with maybe some more medium speed swings. So hit medium speed, stop quick. Doesn't quite have the same ring to it, but you get the idea. Start out at a speed you can manage, and by that I mean make sure you're able to really feel what that follow through should feel like. Okay, you're really able to maintain the structure in the arms, the tilt of the shoulders, the weight forward in the finish. That's going to be important. So we're going to do a couple of these. I'm going to gradually build up the speed for you. The goal here is to keep getting faster while still being able to manage the arms in the follow through. Hit hard, hit harder, hit medium to hard, and stop quick. That one came out pretty nice, pretty good strike, lovely little draw down the middle there. That's landed at 200 meters. That's 220 yards with a punch swing, which gives me some real control and structure to not just my arms, the radius, which is going to improve my strike, but it's also going to build in more repetitive swing path and club face angles. So you're literally ticking all the boxes here. Everything gets better with this drill. And the final point I want to emphasize with this exercise, which is a question that comes up all the time whenever I'm introducing this drill with somebody, whether it's with an iron or with a wood, the question is always, okay, but when do I go to a full swing? Well, the short answer to that is that you don't really ever need to think about going to a full swing, particularly on the golf course. You're always going to swing further around you in the follow through when you're on the course. Okay, it's always going to get a little bit looser, a little bit further. So when you're training, you should always be training with this shorter punch, finish and feel in mind, knowing that as time progresses, you're always going to start to get a little bit longer into the follow through. And the real fact of the matter is that once the arms are parallel to the ground here, what happens after this point doesn't really matter too much at all. So how you finish the swing, how you choose to rehinge the wrists can be something that you learn to do separately. But to start with, you've really got to buy into this short finish. Not worry about, oh, I'm not going to hit it as far. Not worry about, oh, what's going to happen after I've done this drill. Do the drill first. Spend some time actually learning to do this correctly. Watch your ball striking improve and reap the benefits of that more improved, consistent contact. And then you won't even want to think about wrapping this thing up and around your head ever again. So one more time, does it work with the driver? I guess I'll let you be the judge of that. Nice push draw, 210 meters, that's carried like 230 yards. Finished at like 222 meters, which is about 250 yards. If that's good enough for you, maybe you want to give this drill a try. So the hit hard, stop quick drill is one of the best ball striking drills out there. I don't really think there's a better drill for improving your ball striking quickly and effectively with every single club in your bag. And it's also relevant for every level of golfer. I use this with beginner golfers and I use it with the lowest handicap and professional players that I work with. There's a real secret to this exercise that pulls everything together in one and gives you all the benefits just by focusing on one piece of the swing. If you try it and you like it, get down in the comments and let me know what you think. This is truly my favorite drill. I hope you like it as much as I do. And if you have enjoyed today's video, don't forget to hit that like button as it really does help the video to get shared and seen by more people. And if you want to know what comes after hit hard, stop quick, which is a question I get all of the time in terms of how to extend the swing beyond that short finish, you're going to go and watch this video next, which is the 90-90-90 drill, which will just take the follow through to the next level.